headlinesdaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I am Riya Mohanty, and today's headlines are: in India, NRIs are set to campaign for the BJP ahead of the 2019 polls, and batsman Gautam Gambhir has announced his retirement from cricket team. In UK, action has been sought against Pakistani gangs targeting Sikh groups, and the UK should be able to unilaterally cancel its withdrawal from the EU. In Punjab, stubble fire cases have reportedly passed this year, and the mother of the Pakistani-based KLF head has urged him to surrender. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. For detailed news and business updates of the Indo-UK community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: the Global Indians for Bharatiya Vikas will campaign across the country for the next 6 months. It aims to ensure maximum voting and having one political party secure an absolute majority in the forthcoming general elections. It has roped in Somabhai Modi, elder brother of PM Narendra Modi, to carry out its activities. After 15 years of international cricket for India, World Cup winner Gautam Gambhir has announced complete retirement. Gambhir retires after last playing for the country in 2016 against England in Rajkot. He scored 4,154 runs in Test cricket from 58 matches, 5,238 runs in the ODIs and 932 in the T20s. The BJP has said that the extradition of Christian Michel from the UAE was a diplomatic victory for India and could spell serious trouble for the Congress First family. Michelle is wanted in the ₹3,600 crore Augusta Westland VVIP property for use by the President, Prime Minister and other VIPs by the UPA government led by Manmohan Singh. The government has rejected a long-standing demand of the armed forces for a higher military service pay for over 1.12 lakh military personnel, including junior commissioned officers. The Army headquarters is very anguished over the decision and will seek its immediate review. The Supreme Court has allowed the IT department to reopen tax assessment of top Congress leaders Rahul and Sonia Gandhi for 2011 to 2012. This relates to the National Herald case in which the Congress leaders are also facing criminal proceedings. PM Narendra Modi used the Kartarpur corridor linking Pakistan to India to head out at the Congress. He stated that Kartarpur went to Pakistan due to the lack of vision and sensitivity of then Congress leaders. Congress Chief Rahul Gandhi has targeted PM Narendra Modi over employment opportunities, farm loan waivers, the Rafale deal and demonetization. He hit out at Modi over his promise of providing employment to 2 crore youths during the 2014 Lok Sabha elections. Union Minister Uma Bharti has said that she won't contest the next Lok Sabha elections. The senior BJP leader's announcement came days after her cabinet colleague Sushma Swaraj said that she won't contest the next LS polls. Delhi Daredevils has been renamed as Delhi Capitals. This has been done in a hope that it will bring a change in fortunes of the franchisee after a poor track record over the past 11 IPL seasons. Actress Aishwarya Rai Bachchan kept away from the social media for a very long time until joining Instagram earlier this year. She says that the fact that people start seeing it as a barometric reflection of your popularity or status was a put-off for her. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from UK and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are: a report claims that British Sikh girls have been targeted by Pakistani origin grooming gangs for sexual abuse and exploitation over the years. It also claims that these gangs have not received full attention of the authorities due to political correctness. A top European law officer has said that UK should be able to unilaterally cancel its withdrawal from EU. A group of Scottish politicians has asked the court whether the UK can call off Brexit without the consent of other member states. A report from the House of Lords has warned that greater powers given to HMRC to tackle tax avoidance and evasions are undermining the rule of law and justice. The report claims that HMRC has been granted some broad disproportionate powers without effective taxpayer safeguards. Thousands of children missing out on support for diagnosed special educational needs in England is a national scandal. There are 2,060 children in 2018 who have education, health and care plans setting out their needs, but who received no support at all. The PM Theresa May is preparing to sell her Brexit deal as she opens 5 days of debate in the Commons. Debate is due to last 8 hours each day and to begin mid-afternoon. MPs will vote next Tuesday evening. An Essex man is crowdfunding for a legal case as he does not have paper ID and will not be able to vote. 5 English councils took part in May 2018 trials and 11 are due to hold a range of checks in the 2019 elections. Experts advising the government have said that there is not enough scientific evidence to warrant a ban on sale of energy drinks to children. However, the Science and Technology Committee has said that concerns in society and evidence from teachers can justify a ban on energy drinks. PM Theresa May has said that UK is committed to doing trade deals beyond Europe after Brexit. May told MPs that she had discussions at last week's G20 summit on ambitious economic partnership with Australia, China, Canada, Japan and other countries. The Department for Transport has said that GTR must contribute around £15 million towards improvements in services for rail passengers and will make no profit in 2018. The company has already spent a similar amount in passenger compensation after chaos following new timetables. Southampton's football team is set to approach former RB Leipzig boss Ralf Hasenhüttl after sacking manager Mark Hughes. Hughes was sacked 8 months after taking charge, with the Saints ranking 18th in Premier League table. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: cases of stubble burning have come down by 50% in 14 out of 22 districts. This has been revealed by Secretary of Agriculture and Soil Conservation, P.S. Pani. Pakistan-based head of Khalistan Liberation Force, Harmeet Singh, is a name mentioned in connections with nearly every terror case in Punjab. However, his mother has asked Harmeet to surrender before the cops, claiming that her life was ruined since he disappeared. A two-member SIT will look into the 1984 anti-Sikh riots and not a three-member panel. This is being done after the Supreme Court modified its January 11 order. Rajya Sabha MP Pratap Bajwa has threatened to sit on dharna with protesting cane growers against the Congress government over delay in payments. He has also appealed to CM Amrinder Singh for intervention. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has acquired former SGPC chief B.B. Jagir Kaur and a co-accused in her daughter Harpreet Kaur's death case. It also allowed B.B.'s appeal and set aside the Patiala CBI special court order of awarding her 5 years imprisonment. The Delhi High Court has sought the centre's response to allow Sikhs to carry a kirpan and kara in public places. A PIL has contended that there has been a violation of fundamental rights of a Sikh youth who was denied entry into the Red Fort on Independence Day. The Aam Aadmi Party has taken out a march in protest against the civic authorities' inability to find a solution to stray animal menace. The Aam Aadmi Party had earlier launched an indefinite dharna and threatened to pursue legal case against the state government if it fails to find a solution. The SGPC has taken cognizance of damage done to the houses of Siklikar Sikh families and Nishan Sahib in a gurdwara by the police at Valsa village in Maharashtra. Chhattisgarh Sikh mission in charge has been deputed to probe and report that CM Amrinder Singh has sanctioned ₹965 crore for infrastructure development in Gurdaspur district. Out of this amount, around ₹159 crore will be spent on the beautification of Dera Baba Nanak Dhaam. Comedian Kapil Sharma has chosen an iconic sweet house from Punjab to arrange his invitation cards, boxes and sweets sent out to guests, including popular Bollywood celebrities, for his wedding. Several people now believe that Kapil has not forgotten his roots. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources. From accounting firms to wedding planners in your city, all of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.